Oh my fucking god, it took me like 2 hours to write all the shit down for this video, but I finally got done. So now it's time for my week two picks of the 2020 NFL season. As last week, oh god, I was 9-7. I don't know if that was my worst week one start, but that is probably up there as one of the worst. God, I remember like until like a few years ago, I would always be like really good with the week one picks, like 12-4 and up and stuff like that. But now, just not as good. But of course, it also has to do with, like I said last week, no preseason, so I couldn't know how the teams are gonna play in week one, so that probably influenced it as well. But these are the updated standings and the playoff scenes too. In the AFC, the Chiefs have the bye. The Chargers would visit the Jaguars, Titans at the Bills, and Patriots at the Ravens. And the NFC, it's the Bears with the bye, as the Rams visit the Washington football team. The Seahawks are at the Saints, and the Packers are at the Cardinals. Based upon these picks, I'm gonna pick right now the Chiefs and the Saints in the Super Bowl. But we'll see how that continues as the weeks go on, because I guarantee you over half of these teams are probably not going to be on the playoff bracket in a few weeks. So anyways, let's get to my week two picks. I finally, like I said, wrote down all the stats right here. It was a pain to do that. As we start off with Thursday night, as the Bengals will be at the Browns, as the Bengals are trying to avoid 0-2 for the second year in a row, and the Browns are trying to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2017. Bengals won the last game between these two, and they're 3-2 in Cleveland the last 5 years, but the Browns are 3-2 the last 5 games in total, as the Bengals ended their three-game lose streak last time they played them. So the Bengals, they fought hard against the Chargers, just didn't have enough to get it, and the Browns actually got destroyed by the Ravens. I'm both surprised and not surprised at the same time, as tonight will probably be a defensive slugfest. And if that's the case, and you see with the stats, the Bengals would benefit massively if that was the case. Fifth in points allowed, sixth in points allowed, 15th in yards allowed, 10th in passing yards allowed. Although their rush defense is really bad, 28th in the league, and the Browns are 10th best at running it too. So this game would be a defensive slugfest. I wouldn't be surprised if it goes either way, but I'm still gonna pick the Browns for this. But I won't be surprised if the Bengals get it. All right, then it's our Sunday games, as we'll start with a big one. The AFC South, as the Jaguars are at the Titans, and whoever wins will have the lead in the division, as the Jaguars try to go 2-0 for the first time since 2018. The Titans are trying to go 2-0 for the first time since 2008, I believe it was. Titans won the last game between these two. The Jaguars, but the good game they had against the Colts. Gardner Minshew was 19 of 20, so he has the I think he has the all-time percentage record in a game. Incredible, and 3 touchdowns too. Showing Minshew magic might be a thing still that anyone has to take in consideration of. And the Titans, good comeback against the Broncos last week. But God, you got really fix your kicking game, because Kelce missed 2 field goals and I believe an extra point. The game would have been a much different situation if they made those kicks. This will be interesting. Jaguars are 10th in scoring, but as you see their stats, they're not really good. So you got one if they're just lucky or what, as their defense, kind of not good. The Titans' offense was kind of bad, but their defense, really good to solid. Let's see, the Jaguars are, I think they're like 1-4 maybe when they visit the Titans these last 5 years. The Titans regularly beat the Jaguars host. In fact, I think the Titans are 4-1 the last 5 games visit against the Jaguars. I wouldn't be surprised if the Jaguars somehow get it after that victory over the Colts, but I'm going to pick the Titans still to get this. All right, then it's the Panthers at the Buccaneers, as the Panthers try to avoid 0-2 for the second year in a row, and the Buccaneers try to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2014, as the Panthers put up a really good offensive game against the Raiders, but just couldn't win, just like they couldn't last year, as the Buccaneers played just like how I expected against the Saints. Not surprised that they lost. So the Panthers, as you see, really good offense. Their defense, though, not surprised. is going to be probably the biggest problem of the team this year. Buccaneers, offensively, you've seen, are not really good. Defensively, though, this is incredible. They are top six and seven in every category except points. Look at that. Six in points and rush yards, but and seventh in passing yards, but 26 in points allowed. So they didn't bend, but they sure broke a lot. And they can't have that happen throughout the year, or they're going to have big trouble. So it's going to be, are the Buccaneers defense is actually going to show up against the Panthers? For one, that would be interesting. And probably going to come down to, can Brady and the offense actually play good? I'm probably going to pick the Buccaneers just to edge this one out. But I won't be surprised if the Panthers actually pull off the upset and the Buccaneers fall to 0-2. Then it's the Broncos at the Steelers for the first time since 2015. As the Broncos try to avoid 0-2 for the second year in a row, Steelers are trying to go 2-0 for the first time since 2017. As the Broncos won the most recent game, the Steelers haven't beat them since 2015 when they last hosted them. As the Broncos had a defensive slugfest against the Titans, unfortunately for them, they just couldn't get it in the end. And the Steelers had a convincing okay victory against the Giants. Nothing really to say about their games on Monday night. You see, the Broncos stats are not really good. Steelers offense isn't really that good. Their defense, though, other than their passing defense, is really good. They have the number one run defense in the league too so far. That's gonna be really good, and I'm gonna pick the Steelers to get this one. So now we go down to the Rams at the Eagles for the first time since 2014, as the Rams try to go 2-0 for the third year in a row. The Eagles try to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2015. The Eagles have won the last six games, and the Rams haven't beaten them since 2004 and 2001 in Philadelphia. That's how long it's been. Unbelievable. As the Rams had a pretty convincing victory against the Cowboys, maybe because the Cowboys choked. The Eagles, what the hell, Eagles? You had 17 unanswered points against the Washington football team, and then you let them score 27 unanswered points, and you couldn't protect Carson Wentz at all. Oh my god. As the stats show too, the Rams, pretty solid in terms of yards. They just didn't get a lot of points, but that was enough for the win still. They allowed few points, but they allowed a lot of yards. That was bending, not breaking. Maybe the Buccaneers should learn in that regard. Eagles offense was terrible. Their defense though, look at that, is fucking elite. They just allowed way too many points. More probably because the Eagles could not stop a sack to save Wentz's life. Oh man. This will be interesting to see how the two top picks of 2016 will do, but I'm still going to pick the Eagles for this. I guess I won't be surprised if the Rams get it. If the Eagles lose, they're going to be in a deep hole to start off the year where I thought they were going to be 2-0. They got to be watching out for that. And it'll be the 49ers at the Jets for the first time since 2012, as I'm going to move this down. As the Jets won the last game, the 49ers haven't beaten them since 2012, as they're trying to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2017, and the Jets are trying to avoid 0-2 for the second year in a row. As the 49ers had a hard-fought game against the Cardinals, but the Cardinals managed to get like I thought they would, and the Jets got their ass cut, kind of spanked hard against the Bills. Statistically, the Jets, you see, are pretty bad, to no one's surprise. 49ers, though, not really good either. Look at that. Their best category is their 14th best passing yards. They have the second worst run defense in the league. That's not good. And they're lucky Le'Veon Bell's out for the next 3 weeks. That's going to help them out. Oh my god. This does not look good whatsoever for them. I'm going to go pick the 49ers though, but I will not be surprised if the Jets get it in an upset. Then it'll be the Bills at the Dolphins as the Bills try to go 2-0 for the second year in a row, and the Dolphins try to avoid 0-2 for the second year in a row. The Bills have won the last three against them, and they are 3-2 when they visit Miami, as the Bills had a convincing victory against the Jets. Man, Josh Allen put up, what was it, 3 touchdowns and over 300 yards or something like that? He was on a roll, looking really good so far this year. And the Dolphins, man, what the hell happened to you against the Patriots? Jeez, Fitzpatrick for 3 interceptions. I guess the Patriots got their well-deserved revenge from last year's season finale. The Bills, you see, offensively are pretty solid. Defense, though, really, really good. Really elite. That's going to help them against the Dolphins' terrible offense. The Dolphins, because of the way they played the Patriots, they have the worst run defense in the league, but the number one passing off defense in the league. Defense, though, I'm sure they're like middle of the pack, though. But I don't know if that's going to be able to stop the Bills' offense. But more importantly, are they going to be able to put up a lot of points against the Bills' defense? No. Unless they somehow pull off an upset, I'm picking the Bills. Then it'll be the Vikings at the Colts for the first time since 2012. And funny enough, just like in 2012, they met in week 2. I find that funny. As the Vikings try to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2013, the Colts try to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2017. The Colts have won the last two games. The Vikings haven't won since 2008. As the Vikings, well, their offense showed up. Their defense not so much, as Aaron Rodgers had a field day against them. And the Colts, what the hell? You should have beaten the Jaguars without effort, but Phillip Rivers had to throw all those interceptions, and they could not stop Minshew magic. As look at the Vikings, they are probably the most lopsided team so far on this list. Really good offense, but their defense, look at that! Worse in every category almost, it's incredible. Colts, meanwhile, third best passing yards, not really good rushing offense. Of course, Marlon Mack's going to not help much. 19th in scoring points. Their defense, though, is really good, except they allow too many points. So, it's going to come down to this. Will it be an offensive shootout, or will it be a defensive slugfest? And I don't know. I mean, as bad as Phillip Rivers is, he could definitely put up the yards needed to maybe get them in the position to score points, as long as they don't put turnovers on the board. I wouldn't be surprised if the Vikings get it, but I think I'm going to pick the Colts just barely because of that better defense. So then it'll be the Lions at the Packers, as the Lions are trying to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2018. The Packers trying to go 2-0 for the second year in a row. As the Packers swept last year, the Lions haven't won since 2018. The Lions, man, you choked it hard against the Bears. What was it, like 23-3 at one point, and you let Bears and Trubisky make that comeback on you? That's really bad. That's very bad. But then against Lions, typical Lions, and the Packers, offensive juggernaut. That was an incredible performance against the Vikings. As right now, you see, they have the best offense in the league in terms of points, the best offense in yards, second best passing offense, and the fourth best rushing offense. Really good. Their defense, though, is crap. But then again, as long as they have that elite offense, if that continues on, that won't really matter. The Lions all over the place offensively. Their defense is dog shit. Now, the Lions are 3-2 at the Packers since 2015, and they've put up pretty close games against them. But I'm still going to pick the Packers to get this. I won't be surprised if the Lions show up, though, as they've done pretty well job against the Packers these last several years. That'll be the Falcons at the Cowboys, as the Falcons are trying to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2007. And the Cowboys try to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2010, I believe it was. As the Cowboys won the last game, that Falcons haven't won since 2017. As, oh God, what a terrible showing for the Falcons. If it wasn't for the fact that they scored two touchdowns near the end of the game, it would have been just an epic disaster. They got torched by Russell Wilson. Their offense couldn't do anything. This looks like it's going to be a one disappointing hell of a year for them so far. Cowboys, they really choked, disappointed hard against the Rams. But then again, it's the Cowboys. What do you expect them to actually show up? Oh, hell no. I see Falcons, second passing yards offense, number one passing offense, but not good in every category. Their defense is terrible, except rushing defense. Cowboys are more middle of the pack, and their defense is bad. I'm picking the Cowboys for this, unless they somehow choke and let the Falcons get it. Alright, as we finally get to the bottom of the list, as it's the Giants at the Bears for the second year in a row, as the Giants try to avoid 0-2 for the fourth year in a row, the Bears are trying to go 2-0 for the first time since 2013. The Bears won last year's game, as the Giants last won 2018. These two teams, I just remember, have played each other 4 years in a row now. No, 5 years in a row now. Incredible. As the Giants, they played an okay game against the Steelers, but what do you expect? They're just a bad team, so can't really help too much. And the Bears, man, they made one incredible comeback against the Lions. That was a big win right there. As their offense, solid so far. Their defense, that's not good against the Lions. You're going to have to do much better than that, but against the Giants' bad offense, you might have a chance. damn, Giants. Saquon Barkley in your 32nd rushing yards. That's pretty bad. Their defense is solid. I'm picking the Bears for this one. But then again, who never knows? The Bears being choked too, they'll probably let the Giants get it. All right, then we get to our 4 p.m. games. As this will be an interesting battle from first, I mean, worst to first, probably. Well, at least they'll attempt to. As the Washington football team is at the Cardinals for the first time since 2018. As the football team's trying to go 2-0 for the first time since 2011. The Cardinals are trying to go 2-0 for the first time since 2015. As the Redskins, the Washington football team has won the last two. The Cardinals haven't beaten them since 2016. The football team, what an incredible comeback. Down 17-0 and you ended up smashing the Eagles in the end. That was good coach in that regard. That defense, oh my God, that defense was great. Look at the stats too. 9th in points allowed, 4th in yards allowed, 12th in passing yards allowed, but the 3rd best run defense. That was incredible. Their offense, though, that's bad. That's going to have to do massive improvements. They haven't gotten nowhere near the yards, but they got a lot of points, though, so they're going to have to do a lot better than that, especially against the Cardinals, as they have a much better offense, and their defense is not that bad either. This game will be interesting to see which one of them is going to go 2-0. I think it's going to come down, though, to the quarterbacks, and I definitely trust Kyler Murray over DeAndre Hopkins. I keep forgetting his name, so I'm picking the Cardinals to get this. But who knows? Maybe Riviera can get another one out of the football team. Then it'll be the Chiefs at the Chargers, as the Chargers are going to host their first game in the new stadium. As the Chiefs try to go 2-0 for the 4th year in a row, the Chargers trying to go 2-0 for the first time since 2006, I believe it was. No, 2012 is the last time they went 2-0. As the Chiefs, convincing victory against the Texans, and the Chargers have barely held off, but they beat the Bengals in the end, as they got to get better offensively. That defense, though, was pretty good, but then again, when you get to the Bengals, that's not much of a surprise. The Chiefs, offensively, as you see, their stats are, yards-wise, not really that good. They ran the ball really well, and they scored a lot of points, but they need to do a little bit better in terms of yards allowed. I mean, yards, if they want to have any shot to go far to repeat, because, God, 24th in passing yards total. That's not a good start. Defense, though, they're solid. That could help them, too. But I'm going to pick the Chiefs to win this one. When was the last time the Chargers haven't beaten them since 2018, but the last time they beat hosting them, God, that was like 2013 or 14. It's been a long time since they've done it, so they got really get something going defensively to shut down Mahomes if they want to win that. Then it'll be the Ravens at the Texans for the first time since 2014, as the Ravens try to go 2-0 for the second year in a row. The Texans are trying to avoid 0-2 for the first time since 2015. No, 0-2 for the first time since 2018. As the Ravens have beaten the Texans the last two times. The last time when they visited them in 2014 was the last time the Texans beat them, as the Ravens put up a dominant performance against the Browns, as the Texans, at first it looked like they might be able to pull off the victory, but then the Chiefs just roll stomped over them, just like they did in the divisional round. And you see their stats are just bad. Ravens are much better. So I'm picking the Ravens for this. But then again, the Ravens choke too. Maybe they'll just choke and let the Texans somehow get. Oh, God, that would be bad for them if they let that happen. Then it's Sunday night as the Patriots are at the Seahawks for the first time since 2012 in their first Super Bowl rematch in Seattle, as the Patriots are trying to go 2-0 for the second year in a row. The Seahawks are trying to go 2-0 for the second year in a row as well. The Seahawks, although they lost the Super Bowl, they won the last two regular season games against them. The Patriots have not beaten the Seahawks since they last beat them in Seattle in 2008. Without Brady, too, how funny enough. So the Patriots, well, your defense showed up, and Cam, he ran the ball well, got two touchdowns, but passing, that's got a lot of work to do. Especially when you have to go up against one of the best quarterbacks in the league in Russell Wilson, as he put up 4 touchdowns last week, 31 of 35, incredible. Seahawks offense is really good so far. Their defense, that's got a lot of work to do. Maybe the only reason it's that bad because the Falcons had to put up a whole bunch of yards to try and make a comeback, but so even so, that's got a lot of work to do. You're going to have to fix that badly. Now, will the Patriots, it actually doesn't matter if the Patriots defense showed up. It's, will Cam show up? I mean, that two touchdowns rushing is really good, but you're going to have to pass a lot more. You have to put up a whole bunch of touchdowns to stop Russell Wilson. And I just don't see the Patriots do it at. So I'm picking the Seahawks to get that. And then finally, the Monday Nighter, as the Saints are at the Raiders. Still have no idea why they picked that. As for the first time since 2012, as the Raiders are hosting their first game in Las Vegas, as the Saints try to go 2-0 for the first time since 2013, the Raiders are trying to go 2-0 for the first time since 2002. As the Saints won the last game, the Saints haven't won there. I mean, won against the Raiders since 2012. Don't even show the stats right there. There we go. Now the Saints, as you see, offensively, they didn't get a lot of yards. It was, they just got a whole bunch of points off of it. Of course, it helps that they got those two picks off of Bray, which they got two extra touchdowns, I believe, off it. So that helps. Defensively, though, they played a lot better. The Raiders, that impressive offensive showdown against the Panthers, although stat, I mean, yards-wise, they didn't really do that good. They did get a lot of points off it, though. Defense, that's going to need a lot of work on. But then again, if the Saints also didn't get that many yards, maybe they can actually pull it off. It's going to come down to, can they stop, it's not about stopping Breeze, it's about just making sure they don't score a lot of points. If they could do it, the Saints could get it, but I'm not fully trusting the Raiders. The Saints are more balanced, and I definitely trust Breeze over Carr, so I'm picking the Saints to get that. So those are my picks for week two. The Browns over the Bengals, Titans over the Jaguars, Buccaneers over the Panthers, Steelers over the Broncos, Eagles over the Rams, 49ers over the Jets, Bills over the Dolphins, Colts over the Vikings, Packers over the Lions, Cowboys over the Falcons, Bears over the Giants, Cardinals over the football team, Chiefs over the Chargers, Ravens over the Texans, Seahawks over the Patriots, and Saints at the Raiders. I cannot wait to see the defensive slugfest that will be Bengals at Browns tonight and all the other games. So tune in next week for my week 3 pick.